You're tuned in to Janet TV with Coach D.
This is Janet TV on the radio, and you're listening to Bring It In with Coach D, where we catch up with athletes and coaches from around the world. Well, the NCAA Women's Division I basketball tournament is down to the Final Four, the best of the best, and still undefeated Notre Dame, as well as the UConn Huskies. Will one of them stay undefeated, or will Stanford or Maryland surprise everyone and take the title? Whether I think most of us expected Notre Dame and UConn to be in the Final Four, but the number four University of Maryland College Park had to get through the number one Tennessee, as well as defending champions number three Louisville, who they beat 76-73 to earn their spot. Who doesn't like an underdog? We loved watching Louisville come through the tournament and take down the top seed last year. Could Maryland College Park be the Cinderella team this year?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, that's what they're poised to do. They're in the position to be Cinderella. I mean, every year, you know, the tournament, it doesn't happen as much in the women's side, but when it does, it's really exciting that a team from nowhere comes out, beats really big names, and sneaks in there either because of just sheer will or a combination of the other teams taking them lightly, which is, I think, what happened with Louisville. You know, they snuck back up on them. You can't rule them out. They're a Cinderella. They already are. But as far as making it past Notre Dame, I don't think they're going to sneak up on anybody. I mean, you're in the Final Four. You're not an unknown. You have film now. You have several games that you have against, you know, teams that Notre Dame has played. So, you know, they see what works, see how you work against them, what your strengths and weaknesses are, and they pick you apart. And, you know, that's really what has been happening over the last couple of days while they're going to Nashville. They could do it. It's never out of the realm of possibility. But, I mean, there's a reason why Notre Dame is undefeated. What I see is Maryland College Park sticking with them for a little bit and then just getting overwhelmed. Once Notre Dame gets started, you can't stop them. I don't know that there's any team that can.
Well, I'd have to disagree. I'm actually going for Maryland College Park, and they're going to beat Notre Dame, and the only way they're going to beat them is with their size, with 6'4", Alicia Devon, and Brianna Jones. The Terps are led by All-American forward Alyssa Thomas. I thought this was an interesting fact about Maryland, and actually kind of sad. The average home attendance for, and they're 28-6. This season was 4,881, and for the men's, who were 17-15, the attendance was 12,557. So I really hope fans move to supporting the best teams instead of this sport being dominated by the men's game, especially when the women are having a great season. So I'm cheering for Maryland to defeat the undefeated Notre Dame on Sunday, April 6th, 6:30 Eastern. What do you think?
You know, with the attendance thing, that's just the name of the game. When you have the women's right in front of your sport, attendance is automatically going to be lower than the men. But that doesn't mean that it can't change. So they have to keep winning. People come to watch winners, and there's a, you know, history of beating big teams. People want to see it. So they're going to start coming. I would think that their attendance is going to jump up, and I hope it does. They deserve it.
Well, Notre Dame and Maryland are in the same conference, so they know each other's strengths and weaknesses. When Notre Dame keeps teams in the tournament under 60 points, luck has been on their side. Their record when doing this is an impressive 23-2. So Maryland definitely has a lot of work to do, but the Irish had a big loss after the Baylor game. The 6'3 forward senior Natalie Achanwa found out she tore ACL. If you have ever seen or listened to Natalie, she's a gamer and the type of athlete you want on your team. Although she will support her team with her voice in Sunday night's game, I think it isn't the last time Natalie will be on the court. I look forward to seeing her at the next level for sure. But with this loss, look for others to step up even bigger. The Irish have the most outstanding player in regionals. Sophomore guard Joel Lloyd scored a team-high 30 points in the regional game against Baylor. And if she continues to score high numbers with her team behind her, Notre Dame will be unstoppable. But the Irish have the stats and success behind them, no doubt about that. However, in their last meeting with Maryland in January, they only defeated Maryland 87-83 with a last-minute three-point shot. So you know how I feel about teams being able to defeat great opponents twice in one season. Kentucky didn't do it against Baylor, and I don't think Notre Dame will defeat Maryland for a second time this year. Sunday night's 9 p.m. Eastern Final Four game is with number one undefeated UConn versus number 2 Stanford? Heather, what do these teams need to do to win in this matchup?
Coach, this could easily be the championship game. I mean, I don't think anybody looks at this game and says, oh, well, you know, there's a clear, definite winner. Although, you know, looking at the matchups in the last 6 meetings against UConn and Stanford, UConn has a 5-1. So, you know, there's a history there of them winning. There's a history there of dominating. But Coach G was interviewed recently saying, you know, this is a new game, and if you play like you're already winning or play not to lose, you're going to lose. We've all heard that mantra. Anybody in sport, you know, the biggest factor is that UConn has that all-around team. I mean, they really do. They're number 1 in points allowed for their defense. They average 47.3 points a game. That's how much their opponents get. I mean, that's crazy, right? I mean, they keep them low. Under 50 points is insane. So their offense isn't too shabby either. They're number 10 in the country with an average of 82.3 points per game. So they're an all-around team. They've got Dolson, their senior, you know, Hartley and Stewart. That combination is deadly. They will beat you in any kind of way. It's amazing to see that they're kind of like many coaches on the court. They adjust. Coach G had talked about their ability to recognize and react quickly and to change when things don't work. They adjust, and their defense collapses on you. If you watch any highlights of either one of these teams, Stanford or UConn, the intensity level is unreal. So if you ever want to see what it's like, watch one of the practices. If you see how to build a team and how to build that do not want to lose, hate to lose, always want to win attitude on a team, watch their practices because their culture is insane. It's infectious. They've just got all-around players for UConn. And they've got the history of winning. They're undefeated. They have a really well-balanced team, actually. They have, you know, 2 seniors, 3 juniors, 4 sophomores, and 2 freshmen. So they have experience. But, you know, Stanford and the Cardinal has their senior 6'4 forward, Tanae Ogbemeke. She wants to win. I mean, this is the Gatorade Texas year, her senior year in high school. You know, she has a great story behind her. She hustles. She can shoot. She's a forward that can beat you from the 3-point line. She showed that against Brittany Griner. Brittany shut her down, penetrating in the middle. What does she do? Oh, she steps back and starts dropping threes. It's not her strength, but she can do it. They're a fast break team. They like to penetrate, but that's also playing into UConn's strength in the defense and collapsing in. They take away that and make you beat them shooting. Tanae can definitely do it. Points per game. She's 3rd on the list in the NCAA. She averages 26 points per game. She gets 12 rebounds per game. I still look for UConn to take it, but it's going to be an intense championship caliber game.
I think the odds are stacked against Stanford for sure, but it's, like you said, it's going to be competitive. And yeah, I think Stanford's first goal is to score more than 50 points on UConn. You know, if they can do that and mix it up and go inside with their big girls, then you never know what can happen. But like I said, I'm going for UConn as well. I think they're undefeated this year for a reason, and it's going to take a pretty aggressive and a team that's on point to beat them. So I'm not sure Stanford can do it as well. So your picks for the championship game is UConn versus Notre Dame?
Yep, going undefeated.
And my pick is UConn versus Maryland, so we'll see what happens.
Get your popcorn, folks. It's going to be awesome.
Touch back with us. We'll recap these games as well as our picks for the championship game, which is April 8th at 8:30 p.m. Eastern. This is Coach D, and you're listening to Janet TV on the radio.
You've been tuned in to Janet TV on the radio with Coach D.